How you think it looks, you know, that should be your main priority. Your main priority should be getting to God, you know, and asking Him for that blessing or whatever you want to receive.
Right.
You, just like I said, the natural and the spiritual, you work for what you want.
I think we pretty much all have seen that video more than one time. And I feel like if we get there, that'll be the best part of it all. You know, there's so much stuff out here now. Because I feel when I be playing, my cell phone rings, something on the laptop is like, it's so many distractions. It's so many distractions. I mean, even if you cut that off, you got a sister knocking at the door. So, you know, it's so many distractions. But if you get your prayer closet, I'm telling you, it will work.
Amen.
Work. It will work.
Let us stand. Give our thanks and believe God. Such wonder. We're going to take up the offering. Consider all. Let's bow our ears again. Let's offer. Lord Jesus, Lord, we can never say we love you, Lord, enough. Lord, we're so thankful for another service, Lord. Another beautiful young people service, Lord. Lord, knowing that we're all your children, Lord. Lord, teach us, Lord. Lord, teach us how to pray. Lord, how to serve you more. Lord, how to give, Lord, what to give, Lord. Because our desire, Lord, is to walk completely, wholeheartedly in your word, Lord. Bless the people today in their giving. Bless the remainder of the service as the word come forth, that we will receive it with thanksgiving and joy. We just love you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray, amen. Thank you.
spring. I think I might be running into a situation where somebody cheated me at the bank. Joe going back. I pray they give me my humbling instead of this 20 they gave me. That was the Lord's money. How many love it?
Amen.
God's good. And the brother, he's going to need you up here. Would you get the Bibles? Brother John, did you give him my note? How many love it? That's saying, come on, church. Remember, nothing is over. They're old women. Let's go back to worship. Amen. Paul said he wanted to be content in whatever state he was in. God bless all of you. I want to take this little short message, and I pray that the film has done you so good. Somebody said we need to upgrade. That's going to be all the music. No, I don't know about the word upgrade, but I know one thing. We need to, Paul said in Galatians, the 4th and 5th chapter, we need to walk in the Spirit and live in the Spirit.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you, perhaps, you can't worship like them, but maybe you can. It's depending on whether you want to get through or not. Now, when I have a desperate need, it's time to do some business. And I just admire the young people. They forgot about who was around. I feel like young people, y'all need more of experience in prayer. And quit trying to be so pretty. Quit worrying about who around you. You see, God listening to your prayer. Some people can get through a quiet prayer, but some people rise up and say, I don't think he heard me. But some people can do like them young people.
Come on.
And do like Brother Buddens.
Come on, brother.
If it takes hitting the floor,
yes, sir.
If it takes screaming,
come on.
Those sisters come in there and they pour out themselves before the Lord. You don't know God will bend with them. Yeah. God, I come to church one time and nobody was in here but Sister Annie. Good God, you thought somebody else was in the building she was praying.
Yes.
She did some business.
Yes.
My people would just call by my name if they were over themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. I would hear them from heaven and heal the land.
Amen. Amen.
Let's go to Matthew 5 and 6 right quick. I love him, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm not going to hold you long, but just... There's a shortness in your life. Because of us. There's no reason, none at all, why people shouldn't have the Holy Ghost. Now, these people got to be hungry. What was on that field? They got to, the young people got to be thirsty. Now, from this day on, we need to get out of this thing that we can't lift our hands. This thing that we can't stomp our feet. This thing that we got in our mind, somebody looking at us. When you need help from God, you better get some help. I won't say nothing. Oh. You ain't gonna get nothing most of the time.
That's right, brother.
Brother Elijah got up in four weeks and all the way up. Baby know how to get anything. When that baby can't talk, what that baby do? Anybody know?
Cry.
The baby what?
Cry.
Is you in the nest of a baby? See, when the girl, when I cry, it make me feel clean inside. Matthew 5 and 6.
Yeah.
When you get desperate, you cry.
Yes,
Brother Grant talked like he cried. Sister Grant was telling me, Brother Grant, when he was finna go for the operation, he something like he cried the whole night.
Yes, oh,
glory to God. You got to get desperate enough. You people that
Elijah.
I have a big mouth.
Yes, sir. You got a gift, man. Amen.
And some of y'all got a big mouth.
Amen. That's right. Yeah, or not.
But you do silence night when you come to church.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
I've been in the world. I have a big mouth in the world. When I go to the game, you were brave to say I got the feeling and we back it up.
Come on. Come on, brother.
Come on, man. That's it. Somebody been chilling because you got a silence.
Come on,
brother! You let the devil have your moment when you was in sin, and what God can do, he heard your cry.
No, sir!
No. I don't think God gives death, but you cry. You cry in the bed of well. Matthew 5 and 6 says, brother, let's read.
Blessed are they which do hunger.
Blessed are who?
They.
He's talking about who?
Me.
Which do hunger and thirst after righteousness.
And you can't pray at them people in Africa. You get hungry.
Come on, brother.
See, God know what you're doing.
Come on now.
For they shall be filled.
Amen.
Shall be filled. You know why some people don't get nothing? They get up, the prayer don't mean nothing. They get up and listen to other people's prayer, but they're scared to open their voice.
Come on.
Oh, Lord, to go. You set the bomb.
Come on, brother.
Some people make it a habit on their knees listening to other people.
Lord, have mercy.
God, I want you to do it for me.
Come on.
But I got to cry out.
Lord, yeah.
Father, get heavenly calm in the name of Jesus Christ. But you take this message, God, as we cry out to you today, Father. We can't be like the people in Africa, God. But Lord, I love to just cry, God. I'm a baby today, God. And I want to cry, Lord, because you the only one can answer my plea.
The only one
can answer my plea. God, be merciful unto us. In Jesus Christ's name, bless the sick and the suffering. I've taken this sickness away from them. God, remember Sister Bottles and open her eyes, God. I pray that you will in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. 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 I'm here to report on Jesus Christ. In the line of duty, God will protect you from anything.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, brother?
Listen to this next scripture. Get your Bible on this class, this evening class. I want you to see, because let me tell you what, young people, you're not getting into your prayer life. Young people, you're not getting into all the way. You're too quiet. Older people, you're too quiet.
Amen.
Amen. You can't see you lacking something. That's why you haven't got it yet. You're too quiet. Why you ain't got the Holy Ghost? You might be too quiet. I'm not saying you. You said, God, you need me like this. Let me tell you, if you can't hurt yourself, I wonder how God can.
Oh, my Lord. Brother, you preach.
He'll hurt when you can't hurt yourself. But you need to find out, Lord, is this my makeup? To get up and pray quietly? And when I get back up, well, he ain't hurting me.
That's your
makeup. If that's the faith God wants you to have, that's not even faith.
No,
I'm not going on my knees for nothing.
No,
I'm not standing in my holding my hands for nothing. When I come to God, I come for business.
Yes,
God is a business man.
Yes,
and we got I come to do business.
Yes,
what's the matter? Young people, don't pattern yourself after nobody but Christ. When you see you don't have results, you ain't crying.
That's right.
Oh, somebody gonna look at you. When the Spirit of God will hit me in all fell, I say, glory to God, or amen, or something. I don't care. Praise God. This is like heaven to me.
Yes, amen.
What's that next scripture, brother? He listen to this. You want something from God? Proud.
Wow.
If you don't cry, you're worse than a baby. And that's the reason you haven't got a chance. Because you ain't crying out giving it to God. It's something you got to do.
Yeah.
If you want God to do something, that's something you got to do. Praise the Lord. Listen to this. Next scripture. What it is? Mark 10, 46 verse.
Let's go to Mark 10.
Right quick. And I wanted to bring your attention to this. You should brother, give what we come for. We come to church to see our weakness.
That's it.
What we lacking in.
That's it.
We come to church to get a closer walk with God.
Yes.
Not just only here, we come to church for that.
Yes, sir. Amen.
More of you, Lord. And we came to Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus and the son of Timaeus.
A blind man, there's a blind man. We
bring forth to you just like we did last week.
Amen.
Brother Brandon said, Brother DJ, God help themselves. Listen to the statement. That cannot help themselves.
Right? Yes.
Now, most of the time in the denomination, we say, God help them that help themselves. No, God, not so much as that. God help them that care of themselves. And I'm one, in certain situations, I cannot help myself. Now, God expect you to do your reasonable service, and then what you can't do, he'll do the rest. But I want to drill this morning or this evening, God help them that they can't help them. You got condition. You can't give yourself the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
God will help you if you cry out.
Yes, sir.
God help them, Brother James, that can't help themselves. You got to talk to God.
Yes.
Brother Leonard said, if you want to get healed, God need a reef.
Yes, sir.
Now you want to be healed. Blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out. Couldn't see him. He began to do what? Cry. Go back to Brother Bannon and think. Brother Bannon talked like, I'll correct it, but he talked like Jesus didn't even hear blind.
No, sir. No, sir.
Go back and study that. In other words, like we hear them now?
No, sir.
Can hear on this microphone? Talk about Jesus, blind young man, is what even heard was coming to.
That's right. He was so far off.
Let me tell you, when you in need, nobody can stop you.
Amen. Nobody.
Oh, hallelujah.
Glory.
Right.
God will hear your prayer. He began to cry and say, Jesus, thou son of David, Jesus, have mercy on me.
Have mercy on me.
When the last time you prayed for the Lord?
Have mercy on me.
To have mercy on me. I told God to teach me how to pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Read on. Let's listen at this thing. Jesus do what?
Mercy.
He what? Did he cry or he just moaned?
Cry.
You need to cry. I know you don't want to mess up your hell fix, but you got to forget about that hell fix. And give a cry. Forget about that fix. You ain't got no business to make up a pile of nowhere. And now you do some crying, I do some sweat. He that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be fed.
Amen, Father.
Cry out! Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I feel the Holy Spirit up here. He wants some one or more to cry. He wants some one or more to change their identification.
Right.
I'm trying to be like no less. You see the identification, you knew it ain't working, don't you?
It don't stop till you get what it wants. Chicken thing like that, that don't mean they sin.
No, sir.
Remember the message I preached a few weeks ago that silence brought down to me. Even when they shout, he said, Lord, he's a faith.
Yes.
Because he will come and heal.
He will. He will. Amen.
Good man of faith. He holds the house.
Amen.
We underneath cannot.
Amen.
In the end. We need some godly God going to hurt somebody.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Listen to this. St. John 9. Now people go ahead, I pray. So what? You do?
Yeah,
you can never pray enough.
Amen.
How do you pray? Is he hearing your prayer? St. John, my brother.
9.
The 9th chapter. A blind man answers the birdie. Not even help himself. And now he's crying out. And not even the percentage of what Jesus was. But God knew how to hear your cry.
Yeah, thank you, Lord.
But out me being forgiven and brother Rick. St. John 9th chapter. The God of mine salvation heard the woman. The black woman cried. Heard her soul crying and falling on her knees and went to sleep. God sent her alive. He heard her cry.
Yes.
Yes, don't you know what God can do, what he done for others, he can do for you.
Yes.
You want the Holy Ghost? You said, I'm waiting on it. No, he waiting on you.
Yes.
You ought to stay crying till you get it.
That's right.
You young people, y'all think something to go with. And it's going to take the Holy Ghost to go with. God will change you. Last scripture. St. John 9, 23rd verse through the 32nd verse. Therefore said his parents, he is of age. Ask him. Then again called they the man that was blind.
A man that can't help himself. Blind people can't help himself. You got sight and still won't help yourself.
And said unto him, give God the praise. We know that this man is a sinner. He answered and said, whether he be a sinner or no, I know not. One thing I know, that whereas I was blind, now I see.
I know that.
Then said they to him again, what did he to thee? How opened he thine eyes? He answered them, I have told you already, and ye did not hear. Wherefore would ye hear it again? Will ye also be his disciple? Then they reviled him.
I want to be his disciple.
Amen.
And I am his disciple.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Be glad.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then they reviled him and said, thou art his disciple,
For we are Moses' disciples. I don't mind being identified with Brother Branham. We read the Bible, they say, y'all be Brother Branham. You right.
Right.
Because his message in the Bible is one and the same. We know that God spake unto Moses. As for this fellow, we know not from whence he is. The man answered and said to them, why therein is a marvelous thing, that you know not from whence he is, and yet he have opened my eyes.
I don't know who he is.
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
Uh-oh.
But if any man be a worshipper of God,
are you a worshipper?
And doeth his will, him he heareth. Since the world began, was it not heard?
Josh, can you imagine doing the Spirit of the Lord, clapping your hands, stomping your feet? Lord, I need help! Help me, God! Can you imagine that?
Imagine that. Thank you, Lord.
Can you imagine your person coming up to this altar and crying, oh, God, help me, Jesus! Lord, you know, I need help, I need to be filled with the Holy Ghost!
Oh, my.
Oh, you study this match and you do some business with God.
Since the world began, was it not heard that any man opened the eyes of one that was born blind?
Even that can't help themselves.
Since the world began,
God will help them. I know that you can give yourself the Holy Ghost. God has become light. And do that. What's the next scripture we got to close?
Acts, 2nd chapter, the 1st through the 4th verse.
Listen to what happened on the day of Pentecost. Remember, he that hungry and thirst after that shall be filled. But if you're not hungry, you're not going to cry.
Right.
If you're not thirsty, you're not going to cry. If you're not hungry for God's own life, you'll go on with the void in your life. You got to hungry. You got to meet the requirements of what it takes. And you got to stick it and you get it. You got to sing in some prayer. You said, I'm praying. You ain't praying enough if you still stealing. You said, I'm praying. You ain't praying enough if you still lying. You ain't praying enough. Oh, I'm going to pay my tithe. Oh, just, you ain't praying enough.
Thank you, Lord.
So it's a dying son of some. Undying love.
You got to say, Lord, I heard it say, Jonah cried out, undying love, the fault in me, undying love, throw me overboard, undying love, and your ship will go free, undying love. Undying love will make you cry out. As you read. Acts the 2nd chapter, 1 through 4. And when
this is not happening.
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come.
You need a Pentecost for yourself.
They were all with one accord in one place. Yes.
Why the young people ain't getting the young people to come to the church and cry out with them? I don't care if it takes a year, 2 years, 3 years. If the sisters and the brothers can get one another to pray, why the young people ain't doing that? Why the young men and things ain't getting a set aside a service? Brother, we want to come on Sunday and think we want to have a prayer. Why are you doing that? Why are you crying out? Why are we going to come back? Do you have the Holy Ghost? They say, I don't know.
Tracker.
It's a crap.
Tracker.
And suddenly there came a sound from heaven.
It's supernatural. I can't feel on fire.
And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it set upon each of them. And they were all filled.
Yeah. Ain't good enough to be good. You must be born again, Jesus said. and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues.
If you got a gift,
then it's coming. And began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Get your own experience, young people. Brother Bannon wasn't going to let George Smith marry his daughter until he received the Holy Ghost.
That's right, brother.
It's all right in court and everything else, but let me tell you, both of you need the Holy Ghost.
All right.
Let me tell you, don't go by a person because they're sitting in the church.
Yes, amen.
You better go by, do you have the Holy Ghost? And don't you try to make nobody get it, you make the Lord do that. Because you gonna mess up that little brother said, leave people alone. God got a special ministry to handle that. God got a special ministry for counsel, not you. I've seen people, they almost mess up people. A girl had come into church years ago. She had then committed adultery. And y'all know this message, preach if you committed adultery, you got to tell your husband or wife.
Yes,
some of the sisters with their fast selves.
Yes,
went and told the girl, walk for walk, and still let the girl go to the pastor.
Yes, sir.
They went and did it one more. And she confessed to her husband. Her husband, she was a weak person, told her to get the man dead. She got the man, like to kill the man, from what I understand. They like to call somebody death. If God ain't called you to handle sacred counseling, that you need to know. When you get somebody hurt up,
yes, sir. Come on, tell
me. It ain't no job.
No, sir.
When new people come in,
yes, sir.
It ain't no job. It's not even the pastor job. To make people to go to somebody, they got to do that on their own. All the pastors can do is instruct what the master say. We can lead you to a spiritual control. A war, but we can't meet you. Wherever it's not your business.
Yes, sir.
And your business alone.
Yes, sir.
And leave these imaginations what you think somebody done.
Right.
Or you get somebody hurt.
Right.
Somebody's like to beat that man to death. When God do something, he do it.
Yeah.
God got a time and a way.
Right,
if it have to take you to hide, confess it.
Yes,
I just have to take the hide off you, confess.
Yes, sir.
If you want to be right married,
yes, sir.
If you want to give it to God, it's the Lord. When you're in sin, you do all kind of things.
That's right.
Ain't no need to try to say, oh, I didn't heal in this marriage. You're lying. You hadn't been born again and you ain't been pure.
That's right, brother.
You might mess up once, twice, or every night.
That's right, brother. Come on.
When you're sinning, you go and do things of the self.
That's right, brother.
That ain't no big thing, but it's a secret thing.
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you, when you strip that off, you and say, oh, honey, I messed up. I want to get things right because I want to get the Lord. You say, I confess it to God. You wasn't married to God.
Right. Come on, preacher.
You was married to that woman or that man.
Yes, sir.
Oh, they don't need to hear that. Girl, they just come in. You ain't the one to give it to them.
Right.
Come on. You want to clean up all the way with God.
That's right.
And then when you do that, go to God.
That's it.
That's the start.
That's the starting place.
Yes, sir.
I hold it in my heart that I'll die. You will die and go to hell. You mean to go with God and go all the way clean up? Lean up.
That's right.
Lean up.
protect himself. And God help them that can't help themselves. What's the next one, Brother Hicks, in closing?
Joel 2:28.
What is this promise that we read about Acts? The lightning and thunder knew it all right.
And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions.
You want this? Get hungry.
There's a lot of gifted,
but they don't have the Holy Ghost.
Man.
That's true, preacher.
Crowd. You, the only people in the world, can receive the Holy Ghost in your soul, in your heart. There's no other people on the face of the earth can be sealed. You, the only people, can be sealed. That's what I'm trying to say. Prove the Holy Ghost to make the rapture. Every other denomination cannot have a sealed faith. Y'all heard? Out of all the shouting, out of all the gift, but they cannot have a sealed faith to make this rapture. Yeah, it'll just be a few. Straight at the gate, narrow the way.
Man.
A few that fire. There's Enoch 1. God selected a few. That's why he's calling you from different places, the east, the west, the north, the south. He's calling you, he wants you to feel, because there's going to be a rapture. Don't miss it, church. Don't, I got a message on refusal when I can get it. Take your weapon. God kind of help. Take your spiritually. Weapon, God kind of help you. God wants you to save. God wants you to change completely with the old life that you can have. You can mix them. You can't be in the world one minute and be in the message and lack of the denomination and they kind of mix things and then back in the world.
Amen.
You don't pray, cry out, and believe in a message, you won't stay. Read on, brother. He's got to go. In my closing, I would like for you to take these messages home and look at those people. You said, I'm not an expert. Yes, but those people crying out.
Yes, sir.
You're supposed to have the same cry.
My cry.
When you get in need of something.
Yes.
You young man, you need a cry.
Come on.
Sister Anna, sister. Maybe I can't pronounce the name. I Anna was right. Sister Bria was right. When you're trying to pray, sometimes you all get a lot of attraction or interruption. Let me tell you, y'all want to know how to solve it? If you want to know how to solve it, when somebody comes to the room, you know what you need to do? You need to keep, that's when you do holler. Lord Jesus! A life of hunger.
Yeah.
A life of thirst. You give more time. How much time do you give in prayer?
2 minutes,
3 minutes?
Oh my God.
Everybody look at the prophet Brother Brown and the prophet Paul. Them brothers gave, them brothers had a prayer life. I'd rather have canvases on my voice for praying and doing nothing.
Amen.
Than having a cold.
Come on.
We can't, let's go. Let me tell you, I can counsel you. But this is my counsel here. Go to praying.
Yes.
Go spend some time in prayer. Sometimes God allows things to happen so you can cry to Him. God wants you to talk to Him in close. Will you talk to Him?
Amen.
Just as I am, without one thing. Will you talk to Him? If I could get more prayer, and I want to see more prayer in this church among the young people. Look at all y'all young men. Sex, fine, talented. Talented, but do y'all have a prayer life? From Frank to James, Josh, BJ, do y'all have a prayer life? I want y'all to think about it. All the young girls, do y'all have a prayer life? If you know you ain't got the Holy Ghost, then I ain't got the Holy Ghost. You can say that, well, hey, he'll tell you what I'll do. But do y'all have a prayer life to get the Holy Ghost? You'll be ashamed to see it. Do you have a prayer life in the next? Are you crying up? Jumbo, do you have a prayer life? Young people, you ain't getting the main thing on your mind. It's a prayer life. It's a crying to God. How do you think I got this far? Crying to it. I'm lonely. What kind of prayer life? I know somebody you can talk to.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I'm never alone. Oh, no. I'm never alone. He promised.
Brother, brother, it's coming, dude.
dispensers. May the Lord richly bless all of us. Cry, and God can help you. Amen. And without further ado, let us bow our heads. Heavenly Father, truly, Lord, you have spoken, Lord, this afternoon, Lord.